Welcome to our educational channel. From this quantitative aptitude test, let us see another topic, the stock and shares. So some of the examination point of view, some of the competitive exams, even they are asking questions from shares and dividend. Shares and dividend or stock and shares. So some topics are included in this. So let us see what is shares, stock and how the questions will come in this point of view. How to solve in simple and easy manner, easy method, let us see one by one. So when you see this word definition, just if you observe, stock in order to meet the expenses of certain plan, the government of India sometimes raises a loan from the public at certain fixed rate of interest. Okay, bonds or promissory notes, each of fixed value are issued for the sale to public. We know that. So but in stock, for example, if a man purchases a bond of rupees 100, okay, for rupees 100, a man purchases a bond at which 5% interest, okay, has been fixed by the government. So then holder of such bond is said to be how? Rupees 100 stock at 5. So now this we can call it as a rupees 100 stock at 5%. The meaning is 5% is the rate of interest. So interest is which is fixed by the government, and rupees 100. So here is 100 is called the face value. So this 100 we can call it as a face value, right? And usually the period of fixed the repayment of the loan, that is anything if you take including certain price, they'll mention certain cost to find out the rate of interest. So how the stocks are there, let us see examples also, then you can understand clearly. And main two things you remember I wrote, when stock is purchased, the brokerage is added to the cost price. So it is the meaning of this brokerage is, when you come to this word, stocks are sold or bought in the open market through brokers. So at stock exchange, the stock exchange only the companies, there is nothing but they take some commission, that is called the brokerage. So if you purchase the stock, the brokerage is added in the cost price. For example, if you sold, stocks is sold, the brokerage is subtracted from the selling price. So you can remember, by purchasing, this brokerage is added. They'll mention the quotient, what is the brokerage and rate percentage and what is the face value, everything. And how to calculate the annual dividend or annual income. So questions we'll see, these two important things to remember. So by purchasing only, the brokerage is added. By selling, the brokerage is subtracted from the selling price, right? And even come to the shares also. For example, rupees 700 at 60% stock at 797. So instead of that, let me write the question and explain. It's easy one by one. Okay, let us see this question, then you can see the problems one by one. It's easy way. Okay, if you observe this question, what is the annual income derived from rupees 1800, 5% stock at 104? The meaning of this is, it is 1800. So annual income, what is annual income derived from 1800? So here is this value, this is the market value. So market value, 5% stock at 104. That means the market price of rupees 100 stock is 104. So it's increased. The always for 100 rupees, you need to calculate. Out of 100, market value is 100. Now 5% stock is at 104 now. So we need to find out the annual income derived from 1800. So here is income from rupees 100. 5% stock at 104 means 5% per cent. So for every 100, 5 rupees you need to calculate, right? When you come to the solution, so no need of worry about this stock at how much, whatever it is. They're asking only annual income. Okay, so income from, always remember, for 100, for every 100 only will calculate. So income from rupees 100 stock. 100 stock is equals to rupees 5, because 5% per cent for every 100, 5 rupees, the meaning is. Now how much income is derived from 1800? So for 1800 stock, how much you'll get? So that is a simple question. Now income from rupees 1800 stock is, let it be x, rupees x. So direct variation, right? So 100 into x. So this 100 into x is equals to 1800 into 5, just cross multiplication. 100 into x is equals to 5 into 1800. From this, x is equals to 1800 into 5 by 100. 1800 into 5 by 100, just to simplify this, two zeros, 100 ones, 118, so 18 5s are 90. Okay, this is the rupees 90. So annual income from 1800 is 90 rupees. Okay, some questions we not known it of using this. 5% stock at 104. This is the premium which is increasing or decreasing. The terms we'll use, you see in the next questions. But according to this problem, only they're asking annual income from rupees 1800. So 5% stock, right? So for every 100, 5 rupees. So for 1800, how much? So straight one. The reserve value is 90. See few more questions, including brokerage cost and all. We'll see few more sums now. See in this question, how much 4.5% stock at 95 can be purchased by investing 1905? Brokerage is 1/4%. So always remember, when you're purchasing, brokerage should be add, right? So let me take the step wise. So by investing. So always remember, stock is for every 100. So 4.5%. So by investing rupees. So okay, 4.5% stock at rupees 95. This is 95. That means 95 you're investing plus brokerage is 1/4. So by investing this much, because this 95 also out of 100. So brokerage also out of 100 is 1/4. So 95 plus 1/4 by investing this stock purchased, by investing this much, we are purchasing rupees 100. Okay, for every 100 it is always. Right, now whatever the rate of interest, leave it. So 95 can be purchased by investing. How much? 4.5% stock at 95. They mention, no, at 95. So 95 plus brokerage is 1/4. Stock we purchased rupees 100. Now by investing, similarly same, by investing how much as per the question, 1905 stock purchase is equal to dash. So let it be x, right? Just only the cross multiplication, same, x into this. So x into 95 plus 1/4 is equals to 100 into 1905. 1905 into 100. Just only the cross multiplication, because direct variation it is. When the cost is increasing, this value also will increase. From this, you can find out the x value, that is only how much can be purchased. Okay, 95 plus 1/4 stock can purchase for out of 100 rupees. Now for this much amount, how much it is, right? Simplify now, x into 95 plus 1/4. So how much? 381. 380 plus 1. 381/4 is equals to 1905 into 100. Simplify this from x is equals to 1905 into 100 into 381/4 becomes 4/381. Okay, direct calculation. So 4 into 100 is 400. And this is cancelling directly. After cancellation, you get 2000. So final amount. Yes, 400 into this is 5, right? 5 times. 381. 5. So 2000 rupees. That means by investing 1905, so to purchase is 1905, we need to, the total amount is 2000 rupees. So 2000 rupees can be purchased by investing 1905 with this percentage. Rate of interest is 4.5% and brokerage cost. Already they given at stock is 95, we can calculate. So answer is 2000, right? We'll see some more stock can be selling also now. This is for purchasing, right? That's why you added the brokerage. Let's see other type now. Now in this problem, find the cash realized by selling rupees 2400, 5.5% stock at 5 premium. and brokerage is 1 by 4. So it's a selling case, so brokerage should be subtracted. But your thing is 5 premium. The premium means it's more than 100. So plus, premium should be added and discount should be subtracted from 100. That means the stock at 100 plus 5. That means stock at 105. The meaning of this premium. Whenever you can see the word premium, that should be added to the 100. For example, discount. If you use the word discount, should be subtracted. Okay, or at above par, below par, at par. The word also is used in this word. So I'm showing here. Just at par means same as it is PAR. And below. So below par is discount. And if they use the word above par, that means instead of using the premium word, they'll use the above par, PAR, right? Okay, apart according to our question, this is 105 now, stock at 105, right? So we can write now. So by selling here, so rupees 100, by selling rupee 100 stock, cash realized. They said find the cash realized by selling 2400. But for out of 100, this is the value. 5 premium and brokerage 1 by 4. So out of 100, you should calculate. So cash realized is 105. Okay, 105. This is the stock at 105. Brokerage should be subtracted because you're selling. Minus 1 by 4. 105 minus 1 by 4 is 419 by 4. Okay, by simplification. Now this is by selling 100 rupees stock, cash realized is 419 by 4. Now according to this, same by selling, according to our question, selling rupees, how much? 2400. 2400 stock, same cash realized. Realized is equals to X. For 100 this much, for 2400 X. Okay, just do the cross multiplication. So X into 100. So for 100, 419, 2004 is. So cross multiplication. So 100 into X is equals to 2400 into, just a cross multiplication, right? 100, this one, this is equal to this. And 2400 into 419 by 4. Yes, simplify this. So X is equals to 2400 into 419 by 4 by 100. Divide this 100, take this side. 100, 100 cancel, 24. 4 ones are 6. 6 into 419 is rupees. How much you get? 2514. Right? This is the cash realized out of 2400. The main thing is out of 100 only you can calculate for out of 100 stock this much, as per, because the premium no plus 5, brokerage is subtracted because of selling, right? So now cash realized is, by selling 2400 you get 2514, right? And see few more sums. See one more similar sum. Find the cash required to purchase rupees 1600. But condition is 8.5% stock at 105 with brokerage is 1 by 2. Purchasing, right? So getting, buying this is. That means cash required out of 100 you should calculate first. So required for purchasing. So for purchasing, how much? Rupees 100 stock. So 100 stock is equals to rupees, what is this here is stock at 105, so 105 and plus brokerage is 1 by 2, that is, so same out of 100 is 105, same out of 100 is 1 by 2 percentage, same you can calculate. So 105 plus half is 211 by 2, right? Then same cash required as per the question. So cash required for how much? For purchasing It is purchasing rupees 1600 stock. 1600 stock is just we can cross multiplication. That means 211 by 2 into 1600 by 100. So same like previous problem, right? I'm writing here. So 211 by 2, 1600 by 100 it is, divided by 100. That value. So 211 by 2 into 1600 by 100. So cancel this. 211 into 8. So rupees 1688. 8 to the 16. 1688 is the answer for this. Right? This is the straight away questions. They are giving the brokerage and all. We can calculate. Let us see some questions on even shares and dividend also. So in this problem, we need to find the cost of 96 shares. Okay, 96 shares cost price you have to find out. That means you need to know cost of one share first. But condition is rupees 10 share at 3 by 4 discount, brokerage being 1 by 4 per share. Right? So rupees 10 each. Each is 10, but 3 by 4 discount and brokerage is 1 by 4. Okay, therefore, so directly we can write the cost of one share will calculate, right? We need to calculate the cost of one share. So that is rupees. Yeah, if you observe, 10 rupees each. So 10 from this 3 by 4 is discount. So minus 3 by 4, right? 10 minus 3 by 4. For this, brokerage is 1 by 4. So cost, no purchasing. So brokerage should be added. So plus 1 by 4. If you calculate this, this is the cost of one share. So let us simplify this. 10 minus 3 by 4. So 10 4. So 40 minus 3. So 37 by 4 plus again 1 by 4. Calculate this. And rupees 37 by 4 plus 1 by 4. 38 by 4. 38 by 4 is 19 by 2. Calculate. 19 by 2 is again 9.5. Okay, it will be 19 by 2. This is the cost of one share, right? Then, but we need to find out cost of 96 shares. So, therefore, now cost of 96 such shares, same. One share we got. So, 96 means 19 by 2 is the cost of 1 into 96, right? It's a simple calculation. And two table, 4. 8, 48 into 19, how much you get rupees 912. So cost of the 96 shares of rupee 10 each at 3 by 4 discount, brokerage is 1 by 4. Discount should be subtracted and brokerage should be added. After getting, you'll get this, right? These are about the shares and dividend. Let us see with the rate percent and rate of interest questions also in shares and dividend one more. Let us see one more question on shares and dividend. You will get the complete concept easily. Here is the problem is, find the income derived from 44 shares of rupee 25 each at premium, 5 rupees premium. So 25 each at 5 premium, brokerage is 1 by 4 per share, the rate of dividend being 5.5%. Also find the rate of interest on the investment. First of all, we need to calculate cost of one share. Right, then you can get the problem easily. So cost of one share. So already we know that rupees 25 each, right? So 25 plus at 5 premium plus 5, right? And plus the brokerage is easier 1 by 4. So let us take plus 1 by 4. So should be added. Right, this you can calculate. So rupees 25 plus 5 is 30. 30 plus 1 by 4. 34 is 120 plus 1, 121 by 4. Okay, this is the cost of one share. So like this, how much we have cost of 44 shares. Anyway, you have to find out the income derived from 44 shares. And in this cost of, so 44 shares, that is equals to rupees 121 by 4 into 44. You can calculate this. 4 121 into 11 is, so rupees 1331, right? This is the investment made. So therefore, the investment. So investment made is equals to rupees 1331, because total number of shares is 44. So 1331 is investment. Now 25 is nothing but, so here is the 25 is the face value. 25 is the face value starting we discussed. So 25 rupee each at 5 premium. So 30 is the market value, but 25 is the face value. Based on the face value only, the premium discount will be happened. So premium means should be added. So here is the face value of one share is 25. Because 25 mentioned here. Therefore, as per the question, face value of one share. One share is equals to rupees 25. Face value of 44 shares. 44 shares is just 44 into 25. You can calculate this. 44 into 25 is 1100. 1100 now. So now dividend on rupee 100. So dividend is mentioned. Dividend being 5.5%. So 5.5% is for every 100. But it's a total number of shares face value is 1100. Right? So we can calculate this. So therefore, now, or you can take now, dividend on rupees 100, okay, that is equals to rupees 11 by 2. They mentioned 5.5, right? 5.5 is 11 by 2. For rupee 100, 11 by 2 means for dividend on is how much? For 1100 is equals to dash. Right, you can do the cross. So 100 into x is equals to 1100 into 11 by 2. So from this x is equals to, you know, you can cancel 100 this directly. 11 into 11 by 2, so 121. 121 by 2, that is a 60.5, right? So dividend on 1100. So in also income on investment. So income on investment is 60.5. So by income on investment on 100, this is the 60 rupees 50 paisa is income by investing 1331. But they asking as per the question, rate of interest also we have to calculate on investment. So that is a simple. So therefore, rate of interest. So rate of interest is, we got 60.50. Income out of investment is 1331 into 100. Just calculate, there is a rate of interest. So 60.50 into 100 is 6050 by 1331. Just you can calculate this. So it's approximately 4.55%. Right? So this is the rate of interest. Simple. That's by investing 1331, we got the profit 60.5. is annual dividend. Annual dividend on 44 shares is, so 60.5. So annual profit out of investing 1331, 60.50. So rate of interest is 4.55% we got. So the questions are similarly will come shares and dividend. The main thing, if it is the brokerage, should be added as per the cost price by selling, subtracting by purchasing should add. And premium should be added, discount should be subtracted from the face value. Okay, mostly these are the questions are there in stocks and shares and dividend. Some other topics and including this shares and dividend also, some other videos are available, you can go through.